I was hanging round town just a wasting my time, right out of a job and not making a dime.
When a stranger steps up and he says, I suppose that you're a bronc rider by the looks of your clothes.
Well, you figured me right, I'm a good one, I claim. You happen to have a real bad one to tame.
He says, I've got one that's a bad one to buck. At throwing bronc riders, he's had lots of luck.
When he pulls out a 10-spot, I says, I'm your man, for the bronc isn't living that I couldn't fan.
So he says, get your saddle, I'll give you a chance. And we hopped on the buckboard and rode to the ranch.
Well, down in the corral, a standing alone, was an old caballo, a strawberry roan, with little thin ears that were crimped at the tip, and a big 44 brand was on his left hip.
His legs are all spavined, he's got pigeon toes, little pig eyes and a big Roman nose. He's ewe-necked and old, with a long lower jaw. You can tell at a glance he's a regular outlaw.
Well, I buckled my spurs and I'm feeling just fine. I pulled down my hat and I coiled up my twine. I piled my loop on him and well, I knew then, if I rode that pony, I'd sure earn my pin.
He bowed his old neck and I'd say he unwound. He seemed to quit living down there on the ground. He went up in the east
and came down in the west, with me sitting on him and doing my best. Well, I loses my stirrup and also my hat, and I'm gone at leather as blind as a bat. He's the meanest old bronco I've seen on the range. He can turn on a nickel and give you some change.
A phenomenal jump sent him way up high, left me sitting on nothing way up in the sky. I turned over twice as I came down to work, and started in cussing the day of his birth.
I find there's still ponies that I cannot ride.
There's some of them living, they haven't all died.
But I'll bet all my money that no man alive can stay on old Strawberry when he makes it.